It's Nigerian street donuts or Nigerian fast food donuts. My dear, one thing I know is that I will never buy donuts from fast food. Abi, what do you think? As in, fast food donuts in Nigeria, they are too expensive. Well, you can buy Nigerian street donuts cheap. Now, let's find out how Nigerian fast food donuts are being made. In this video, you're going to be finding out the similarities and the differences between Nigerian street donuts and Nigerian fast food donuts. Why are Nigerian fast food donuts more expensive? Why would I go to fast food and they will tell me donuts is 200 naira when I can get it 15 naira on the street? I'm going to be looking at these two different kinds of donuts. And if this is your first time stopping by Debbie's Kitchen, you're so welcome. And if you've been here before, good to have you here once again. This is the making of Nigerian fast food donut, and that is my yeast in warm water. I added sugar to it, and I'm adding my flour into my bowl. Now, after adding my flour into my bowl, I'm just going to add in one egg and add in my yeast mixture. One thing about Nigerian fast food donut is that it is carefully made. The ingredients are carefully sought after and they add them carefully. They don't do it anyhow. As in, after putting my flour, I'm going to add in one egg, then I'm going to add in my yeast mixture into my flour. You can decide to use instant yeast for this, but me, I did not use instant yeast, so I had to proof my yeast in warm water with sugar before adding it into my flour. Now, one thing that used to really tire me about this Nigeria fast food donuts is that you have to knead. As in, if you really have to knead your donuts, you cannot just do it anyhow and fry. That is one major aspect that makes Nigerian fast food donuts more expensive and unique. If you do not knead, then you are not going to get this donut recipe you are seeing on the screen. You really have to knead to get this donut recipe, this too sweet fast food donut you are seeing on the screen. If you want to make your donut looking at that, you need for at least 10 to 15 minutes. And kneading can be a bit exhausting. And I'm going to put the link of a video that I talked about tips of kneading and how to overcome that. But first of all, let's leave that one. Let's talk about the kneading. After kneading, most knead until you have this stretchy look. They are going to keep and allow it to proof from between 30 minutes to 1 hour, depending on your environment. If your environment is warm, it will not take you more than 30 minutes. But if your environment is cold, you may need to heat up your oven and turn it off and keep it in your oven for between 30 minutes to 1 hour for your dough to proof. All right, if you don't know the meaning of this proof or rice, my dear, increase its size to like twice or triple its size. Now let's go to how Nigerian street donuts are made. I love Nigerian street donuts, as in sharp donuts, no stress. You just need these ingredients you're seeing on your screen. Just add everything to your flour. Don't worry, the measurement will be in the description box. And this one will give you between 8 to 10 pieces of Nigerian street donut, correct donut though, that you will not stress yourself to need. After, and I'm using instant yeast, so you see I'm not proofing my yeast. I'm even using butter here. Most Nigerian streets do not, they do not use butter. As in, who dash you butter? Do not that is sold for 15 naira. How much is butter? They will just use vegetable oil and mix it and go on to adding warm water like I'm doing here. After which, they're going to mix their dough. After mixing their dough, they're just going to cover and allow to proof or rise. I've said it, proofing or rising is when you want it to really increase in size. So Nigerian street donut, they do not stress themselves to knead. Oh yeah, we are done mixing the thing. Let's cover it and allow it to proof. Sharp. I call this sharp donut, and that is why it is cheap. Unlike the Nigeria fast food donuts that you will have to knead. Now look at it. Now we are back to our Nigeria fast food donuts. It has proved, it has increased in size. You can see the way it's looking because of the kneading. It is so soft and it's so fluffy. Even from the sides, you're going to see the way it's looking so different from the Nigeria street donut. And most of the time, Nigerian fast food donuts are being weighed because they sell them at the same price. They want to make sure that they have constant weight. Like, yeah, I'm going to weigh my own to be 70 grams each, then I'm going to roll them and set aside. When Nigerian fast, for Nigerian street donuts, who bothers weighing? You just go, that's why when you want to buy, use the fork to look for the one that is big and pick the big one inside there. You that do not come early, you get the small ones. But this one, they weigh. So whether you're coming early or you're coming late, you're going to get fairly the same size with somebody that bought earlier than yourself. So this is after weighing. I'm going to roll my dough now and keep it carefully. You can see the way I'm handling the dough, even with care, so that when it's done, even you will know that this donut has gone through a series of processes. Then I'm going to keep it and allow it to proof around like this if I want to make something like jam donut, like what you're seeing on the screen. But if I'm not making jam donuts, I'm going to go on now to make holes in it after rolling it around. That's if I want to make something like what you're seeing on the screen, as in the normal round donut. I'll go further. I won't leave it round like this. I'm going to use my nozzle to make a hole at the middle. For your Nigerian fast food donut, you must have your equipment ready. You can improvise like Nigerian street donut. I'm going to show you how they're going to roll Nigerian street donut later on in this video. Now we're going to finish and set our dough to proof. Now we're going to be back to our Nigerian street donut. Oh yeah, you can see the way I'm handling it. No time. I'm not even taking caution. Just get your dough together and I'm going to roll it now. Roll it sharp, sharp on the surface as in you want to eat donuts. Which kind protocols are you going to be doing like the Nigerian fast food donuts? You are not selling it. You just want to have something yummy for you and your family to enjoy. This is the kind of donut you opt for. So I'm going to roll it now. Roll it in flat and cut. Most of the time, people that make Nigerian street donuts, they don't have donut cutter like as I'm using here. As in, where is the money to buy donut cutter? Now that things are expensive in Nigeria, who send you donut cutter? For where they will just use anything they find available. Like me, I'm going to be showing you what I use if you do not have a donut cutter, like a cup. So I'm going to use a cup to cut this round circle. I use my nozzle to make the hole at the middle. And you tell me you don't have nozzle. I know most persons do not have nozzle. And you want to sell donuts or make donuts for your family. If you have a bottle, you can still make this hole and set your dough to prove. It is what I call sharp, sharp donut. No stress, few ingredients, and you will still have something nice at the end of the day. Along the Nigerian fast food donuts that I had to place in a paper to make it look tush, this one, I just placed it in a tray that I dusted with flour and allow it to proof. Then I am going to go on now to fry. This is after increasing the size or rising. The frying is easy. Once your oil is heated, you stir. Once it is golden brown or slightly brown the way you like it, you take your Nigerian street donut away from the oil and keep in a serviette or sieve to strain excess oil. If you don't have serviette, just keep sieve or basket. As in, let it strain the oil, then you set it aside and this is what you get at the end of the day. It still looks good. Some of them are big, some of them are small. That's what you get in a typical Nigerian street donut. The sizes are not equal because they are not being weighed. We are back now. So our Nigerian fast food, and you can see it has proof beautifully. As in, when you see the presentation, you know it is different from the Nigerian street donut. Now, your oil must not be too hot like the Nigerian street donut. It must be fairly hot because you really want that white line. You know the white line you see now when you go to fast food donut, it must be there. And the kind of, the temperature of the oil used in frying plays a very big role. Unlike the Nigerian street donut, you can see at the side of the screen, as in, anyhow, just put it, the oil is bubbling. But if you notice that the Nigerian fast food donut, the oil isn't bubbling that much. It is slightly hot, so you're going to fry slightly on medium low heat, not so high, until it is brown on both sides. And when one side is brown, you turn the other side because we really want the white line. As you are seeing here now, you can see that white line. It is not in the Nigerian fast food donut, street donut. Now, if you want to make this other kind of donut, like your jam donut, you deep fry. I'm not using a fry pan for this one now. You're using a pot. So you're going to put it. You can see the oil is not bubbling like the Nigerian street donut. It's going to bubble slightly. And once it is brown on one side, you turn the other side. And when it is evenly brown, you will see that white line. Distinct. That is the signature look of Nigerian fast food donuts, to make you know that this donut has gone through series of processes. As in, now when it is fully brown, you can see the white line distinct. You're going to take it out of the oil, and this is how you make Nigerian street donut and Nigerian fast food donut. I love Nigerian fast food donut because it is tush. Look at the normal round one that I made. You can see how beautiful it's looking. And most of the time they put it in sugar or they dust it with sugar just to add to make it look more attractive. Unlike the Nigerian street donut, where is the sugar? Who wants to use the person's sugar? Who will give you sugar? You gotta put sugar by yourself where you get some. But this one, they add sugar to it. It's more expensive, so they really take their time to make it look presentable and attractive for you to buy, so that when you pay your 200 and above or whatever amount you pay, you know that it is worth it. And when you cut it, it is so light. It is fluffy, as in the inside is light because of the kneading, the egg, the butter that is being used. It is really soft and fluffy. You can see the jam donut looking so soft and fluffy and attractive. I also love my Nigerian street donut. It is not so fluffy, but my dear, it is satisfying. Good to have you here. See you next time. Bye bye.